And that's a division of the BIOS organization.
All right. Now, Steve, would you like to give us a little background about yourself and the BIOS energy system before we get onto this really great topic tonight?
Sure. The BIOS organization started back in about 2004. We were building panelized homes. Simply went to a cocktail party, and I told somebody that I built panelized homes, and they looked at me and said, "You build trailers?" And I'm like, "Yeah, no." So I did a little research. Panelized homes are Energy Star rated, so
okay.
I went to the next level and called the Department of Energy, and they said, "Hey, you know, look at zero energy," and that kicked it up a little bit more. And like a zero energy home is a home that uses less energy than it produces. So I thought that was kind of cool.
It
that
is.
Would be the direction that I would head in. 2004, market was still pretty good. I was a real estate broker, building houses, life was good, and market increased, and I ended up designing and starting construction on a Green Living Expo. 2008, the market crashed, and you know.
And all is history.
So, and
here
all is
we
history.
Are sitting again, here talking about it. So, in terms of your energy company, what can you tell us about your organization, and what's your mission here in Connecticut?
The mission, in all honesty, it's pretty powerful. It's to actually make a dramatic difference in the world. To better the world and make an impact that will actually have I'm gonna freeze up on it,
but have
an impact that will impact all race, creed, color, and religion, and that's huge.
Yes, it is.
So I kind of, you know, I get scared at
mentioning
it because people look at you and go,
he's over the top, right?
Yeah, no, not really. That's
no,
where we're
not.
Headed.
No, and you're also doing something with a car
yep.
that you might want to encapsulate a little bit here about.
Sure. Started out, you know, when I was 18, I was a framer, and so that was kind of the experience, and got into building. I built some homes and worked for others, and then got into the zero energy side of it. And then when the market crashed, it really left me with nothing but a 72 Mustang. So I'm like, I'm not going to be building a lot of houses, because I had 5,000 pricing requests from all over the world in 2008 to build zero energy homes. And that happened, if you think back and remember that point in time where if you called Countrywide or any of the other major lenders, the person on the other side said, "Yeah, we're not allowed to lend right now. We're restructuring." Yeah, that was the piece that I caught. So
after they gave money to every
yeah,
person
okay.
on the
so,
face of the earth.
I guess I'm not going to be building any houses for a while. The market in the last couple of years, I could still sit here and go green building, good. It's, you know, it's better than, you know, stick building and all that. But the point is, if you want to focus a whole company and move forward, the market just really hasn't caught up to it yet. So
right.
I've been kind of looking around and going, you know, what else could I do? And it kind of came down to, you know, mother necessity. I'm looking at this old Mustang that I have, and it's got a straight six and a 429 engine compartment. I'm going, there's a lot of space underneath this hood. And I've, because I'm an energy guy and always have been, I've studied these hydrogen generators, and I thought, lots of space. I could probably put a giant truck-sized system in the car, and because it's only got a little straight six, I probably get a dramatic increase in gas mileage. And then I would drive it cross country and get publicity for my green building business. And
that's great.
Seemed to be a, you know, kind of out of the box, half crazy thing to do. But I posted it on Facebook, and one of the founders of MTV called up and said, "That's a fantastic idea. Let's make a movie."
Oh my gosh.
And we haven't made the movie yet, but through Comcast, I mean, we've probably filmed 5 hours in the last couple of months.
Right.
We did Comcast did a trailer for me on the car project.
You can put this up
and,
too out there.
And today's
These
episode program, will be there.
This is wonderful. And so involved in energy, people are always, you know, here we are in Connecticut, we're always thinking about how we can save on our energy bills.
Right.
So we have certain companies in the area is it wise to look around and evaluate how we can, you know, restructure our energy bills by receiving invitations from a variety of companies that are stepping up into the energy system?
It is always wise to investigate and research thoroughly, whether it be the energy reseller, whether it be a company that says, ooh, we've got these hydrogen generators and you'll double or triple your gas mileage. It's still user beware.
Okay.
Know, be careful. You were talking about a magnetic motor that you found, and you paid somebody to get the information.
I paid
but
to have it shipped to me.
The bottom line is, can you go to Home Depot and buy one of those yet?
No.
Can
you,
go to AutoZone and buy one of these hydrogen generator systems?
No.
And there's a company sitting there going, we will double your gas mileage or your money back guaranteed. No.
Nothing.
It's not there
no.
yet. So the hydrogen system is new. The you know, I won't
it's
say
been
it started,
around
it's
a
been
little
around,
bit.
But it's not a proven technology in terms of the masses, in terms of somebody standing behind it and saying,
this actually works.
This works. And if you buy it from us and it doesn't work, we'll give you your money back.
Yeah.
That doesn't
That's
exist.
Where we're at
and
right
until
now.
Until that exists, it's not really going to take
okay.
off. Okay. In terms of the energy companies, huge industry as deregulation came
yes.
in.
Yes.
And with everything else, there's going to be good companies and there's going to be bad companies. And the only point is to look at it, and you want to really look at a couple of things right off the bat. You want to look at what is their intro price.
Okay.
You can go to the utilities website and you can see all the list of all of the resellers that are out there and what their current prices
okay.
are.
Okay.
There's roughly 22 companies in the state of Connecticut. 9 of them right off the bat have prices higher than the utilities.
So forget
so
them.
So just because they're a reseller,
yeah.
it doesn't mean you're saving money
right,
right off the bat. It's competition, mm-hmm. and everybody has something slightly different to
okay.
offer. You'll look at all these 22, and some of the companies will offer 100% alternative energy. That's great. And the price might be a little bit higher. And if you're willing to say, it's worth it to me to pay a little bit more to do that, then you should do that.
Okay, what's 100% alternative energy mean?
Right now, I think everybody is like 20% alternative energy, okay? When you say alternative energy, and we'll call it regular.
Regular.
Regular is going to be mostly oil, coal, or nuclear.
So okay.
Those are the big three that the country uses to create electricity. We now have, obviously, solar. We have different types of natural gas systems. Wind. You know, you have hydro.
Okay.
So those are alternative. Those
are
nice. You know, if the hydroelectric plant, something goes wrong, we're not all going to glow for 1,000
oh,
years.
Oh, okay, great.
Know? So this is good.
So that clears up a lot right there. And so let's get on to tonight's topic. What is green building technology? And that's what we said we were going to talk a little bit about. Green building, your company, green building technology.
Keep it simple. It's BIOS building technologies. But green building, to keep it really simple, is start to finish energy efficiency and fair trade. It's looking at a way of building that is simply healthier.
Okay.
And more energy efficient. You know, there's been trailers that have been built for years, and the cancer causing agents
yeah.
that they had in there. You know, you walk in, it smells.
Yeah, hi.
Give me a clue. If you
formaldehyde,
walk in
yeah.
and something smells bad,
it's bad.
It's probably not good for you. Okay. So you want to be building your building without insulation that is going to kill you.
Yeah.
Okay?
So when we're talking about green building technology, we're talking about energy efficient technology with proper components
right.
that are healthier for us and you know, are going to save us energy. So
healthy
is it wood?
Healthy and energy efficient.
So different wood or different?
Different products, and it really becomes regional. There are some areas in the world where, you know, wood framing is more prevalent.
Right.
And that has a lot to do with the type of wood that is available. Canada has a fantastic supply of great framing wood. You can go other forests and find, oh, there's lots of wood here, but that wood, it's not the same. It's not as soft, and there are different qualities, and you know, everybody has their own thing. There are areas in the world where there's masonry, there's concrete. Obviously, we have all of them, but it's more conducive to certain areas to use one or the other.
One of the goals
is to use what you have locally, if possible.
So in Connecticut, what would you give the
In Connecticut, we've got a good amount of all of
it.
Well,
this
is
good.
You can kind of use concrete, you can use masonry, you can use steel, you can use wood. We have a fair supply of all of it.
Which is exciting because now we can, as you say, take and use these different types of products.
And they all have different qualities and make them better or worse for different applications. So
with that in mind, how would you put together a greenhouse in Connecticut? What could you say, well, I would use masonry on the outside, or I would use a different wood on the inside, or would you put it all together in a certain way if you were to do it for us?
If I were to do it for us, I would tell you it's like everything else in the world, and it's by starting with the customer and determining the needs.
Okay, that's
and
true.
And balancing the benefits. I can't tell you that there's a huge difference between, you know, one or the other and go, oh, it's gotta be masonry.
Okay.
Masonry, good, very strong. It's gonna last a long time. Wood. A little more flexibility, you know, steel, again, very strong, very fire resistant. The wood tends to be more cost effective.
Right.
So you have to balance it,
okay.
And everything kind of comes back to, you know, it's the socioeconomic impacts of green building. The economics are huge. You have to look at the overall budget and what you're trying to achieve, and it could be that this family has allergies, and you may say, let's just go with concrete, because there's no wood, there's nothing, you know, off gases and everything.
Right, right.
So you may go in that direction. Somebody else may say, I like the natural feel, I want the wood paneling, I want to be able to hang a picture easily without having to, you know, pound into the concrete.
So if we're thinking of that, do we now as consumers of energy and of building products, should we take into effect our own personal lifestyle
Absolutely.
In terms of our behaviors and what we need, as opposed to, oh, I like that house, I want that house.
Right.
I'm going to build this house because I like the design. We have to think more of ourselves now.
It's all a balance. And, you know, like the market crashed and I kind of lost everything.
Yeah.
I got a little philosophical. And I kind of created the BIOS philosophy, which is green, healthy, holistic, organic, sustainable, and energy efficient. And it's kind of